Everybody, Johnny B. Good here. Welcome to Matfield Green, Kansas. We are still traveling on Interstate 35, which is the Kansas Turnpike, northerly bound. Today, once again, it is Thursday, November 20th, 2014. Local time here is 1:29 p.m. Temperature is a beautiful 43 degrees. Not a whole lot going on, but I thought I'd show you the prairie grass, prairie terrain of Kansas. This is somewhat unique to this state. Sometimes you see this in some other state, but this one here, I think it really says, I'm in the middle of Kansas. I've been looking for Dorothy over the years. I've never found her. Right now we're down to 727 miles to Hebron, Kentucky, and I would like to say hello and greetings to Tom and Eric Smith. First of all, Tom, yeah, if ever I'll be going through Terre Haute, you bet. You bet I'll be parking over there at the Pilot and be happy to share a cup of coffee with you. But right now I only have 6 hours and 49 minutes available to drive. I'm hoping that's enough to make it to St. Louis. Not sure. Once again, the delivery date and schedule of this load was tonight at 2300 hours Eastern Standard Time. Unfortunately, I don't know if I mentioned this back in Vernon or not. According to PeopleNet, I was supposed to pick this load up on the 17th, which is on Monday, at 1700. So I showed up somewhere around 15 minutes before 1700, or 15 minutes earlier, only to find out when I got there that the shipper told me that this load was supposed to be picked up at 1600, making me an hour late. Therefore, resulting in $120 late charge. Hey, I was there early. I was there on time, according to PeopleNet. But the shipper and the broker did not exactly communicate it that well. Anyway, when I got there, it took them at least 3 to 4 hours to get me loaded. And by the time I got loaded, it was somewhere around 9:30, 10 o'clock my time. And by then, I decided to just sleep right there by the shipper, finish my 10-hour break, since I already had, you know, four or something hours in there. So I finished my 10-hour break, woke up at 5 o'clock in the morning, and took off. When I got to Barstow, I found out I had a flat tire. Finally, that tire went flat. It had a big, big nail on it. So, it took them at least another 2 hours or so to get that tire fixed. Don't forget to enjoy the scenery here. So now, I'm not going to be able to make it at midnight in Kentucky, obviously. So right now the situation is, they're trying to reschedule this load. Initially, the broker said, you might have to deliver Sunday or Monday. I said, why couldn't I deliver tomorrow night? Because McLean only receives at night. I don't know why that is, but I guess during daytime they load their trucks. At night they receive their goods. So I asked them, I said, well, don't they receive on Friday nights? And the broker couldn't honestly give me an honest answer. So they're trying to scramble into trying to figure out what to do with the load or when it delivers. Right now, I don't know whether, I mean, if it was Sunday or Monday. I mean, obviously, I can't sit on this load until Monday, right? So either they're going to have me drop it somewhere or swap it with somebody, or right now your guess is as good as mine what they're going to do with it. So that's the whole scoop, nothing but the coop. CRST over here has a load of railroad tracks. I would imagine those railroad tracks are made of high temper, high grade steel, right? Those are not just mild steel. I was watching the History Channel not too long ago, back in the 20s or 30s. That one of the biggest problem they had was, over time, those railroad tracks would start stretching out like bananas, or they would, you know, they would roll kind of wobbly up and down because of the stretching and pressure. In fact, one of the story that was told, I think it was in St. Louis, that one of the sales manager for the company that sells the railroad tracks guaranteed that his steel will not bend or will not stress or all that stuff. And so he invited all the high polluting, mucky to muck, the richest people in St. Louis to ride on the train to prove, you know, to assure everyone else that, you know, his railroad tracks was the highest quality. Well, they were all wrong. All of them died on the train derailment accident, because that's exactly what happened. The railroad track started to kind of bend, or kind of like a roll up, or yeah, like a roll up. It rolls up and down. So yep, each and every one of the people on the train, the richest in St. Louis, all died, I guess, according to the History Channel. I guess some parts of Minnesota are kind of this terrain, I guess. Let's find out what's on the other side of this bend. Who knows? We might find something interesting. Bazaar cattle crossing. Bazaar cattle crossing. Yeah, just as I suspected. Another prairie grass. Endless prairie grass. Anyway, once again, I am very sorry for my mood for these couple of days. The squeaky wheel of life got to me. God knows I got a lot of squeaky wheels. We'll catch you guys later. Have a good and godly day, everybody. Johnny B. Goodyear. Peace. And that's a wrap. Cut it. Cut it. Cut it.